Big G's roasted butternut squash enchilada casserole. Yeah, that's a mouthful, but so is this dish. Let's go. First up, that butternut squash. Let's get that baby open. Wait, did that just open up with a touch of olive oil, smoked paprika, and a pinch of salt? Am I tripping? Of course not. First, you want to slice it open. You're going to see those seeds. Now, you're going to grab a big spoon. Once you grab that big spoon, you're going to dig all those seeds out. Now, go ahead and add that olive oil, some smoked paprika, and a touch of salt. We're going to throw those in the oven, and we're going to go ahead and roast those babies. Now, butternut squash is full of nutrients. Vitamin A, vitamin C, potassium, antioxidants. Potassium is known to lower blood pressure, so this is an excellent vegetable to add to your tool bag. Now, add some onions to the pan. We're going to throw both of these into the oven, set it at 400 degrees, and we're going to roast these, baby. Hence the name, roasted butternut squash enchilada casserole. Now, while that's roasting in the oven for at least 30 minutes, let's get the rest of the ingredients popping. You got onions, shallots. Heard someone call them shallots the other day. Cilantro, green onions. And we have a nice spice mix, cumin, onion powder, turmeric, garlic, a pinch of salt, and some smoked paprika. That will have your kitchen smelling oh so good. And I have my favorite can of diced tomatoes and green chilies. Also my favorite can of enchilada sauce. Yes, you can do that fresh and make it yourself, but I didn't feel like it. We got some corn tortillas. I got two different shapes. I'll explain that later. Black beans, also from a can. A three cheese blend, queso, Monterey Jack, cheddar, some olives, and an avocado. Yeah, y'all. We making guacamole, baby. Let's get to that guac. First, you need a ripe avocado. Go ahead and split them open. Bam. Take that side, scoop them out with a spoon, throw them in the bowl. That other side that got the seed in it, got a tip for you. Take a big knife, whack the seed right down the middle, twist it, pop it out, toss the seed in the trash. Then go ahead and scoop that other half out, throw them in a bowl. Get them nice and mixed in there. Then you're going to go ahead and add you some cilantro, some green onion, a bit of cumin, and then you're going to go ahead and squeeze a little bit of that lemon. Don't get crazy with the lemon. Stir that all up, and bam, you got you some guacamole. Nice and simple. I promise you, your guests will love it. If you want to keep that guac bright and green, well, Big G got a tip for you, and it don't involve lemon juice or putting a seed in the middle of it. All you need is some saran wrap. Press it down into the bowl. Make sure it's nice and tight. That way the air can't get to it. That way oxygen can't oxidize those avocados and churn it to that ugly brown color. While that butternut squash is roasting in the oven, let's get some Mexican rice popping, my friend. Perfect rice is just trusting the process and your measurements. Get 2 cups of water, 1 cup of rice. Get that into the pot, turn your heat on high, bring that to a boil, make sure you swirl that around, throw that lid on there, and let it go for 15 minutes straight. Do not play peekaboo, okay? You're gonna need to let that water evaporate. Now, while that's cooking, you have options. I choose to get my boogie on, y'all. Okay, after 15 minutes, take that pot, take it off the fire. Again, do not peek. Let that sit for 5 minutes, all right? Let that steam continue to soften up that rice. Now, after 5 minutes, go ahead, take it off and let that steam out. See what I'm talking about, y'all? Then you're going to take a fork and you're going to go ahead and start from the outside and you're going to fluff that. Go ahead. Yeah, there you go. Look at that. Not sticking. Perfect individual kernels, okay? So now once you fluff that, we're gonna turn this into some Mexican rice, okay? Take a half a pack of your favorite taco mix. This is mine. I'm gonna sprinkle it all in there. Look at that. Ooh, I like the way that color looked. Look at that. Get it in there. Yes. Then you're gonna grab some of that enchilada sauce, pour him all off in there. Then remember those tomatoes and diced green chilies? Yep. Pour those in there as well. Save half of it because some of that's going to go into the puree. Then you're going to mix that all around. Yeah, look at that. That looks beautiful. Look at all those little lovely fluffy grains of rice. Yep, there you have it. Mexican rice hack, my friend. Puree time. Yep, get those roasted butternut squash out of the oven. Put them in the fridge so they can chill. Once they're chill, get you a knife and you're going to score that. Then you're going to take a big spoon and you're going to scoop out all that beautiful orange meat, dump it in the blender. That spice mix we had earlier, dump that in the blender. Those roasted onions, don't forget about those. We're building flavor, dump that in the blender. Then you got the onions and the shallots, not shallots. Please don't say shallots. Dump that in the blender. Then I'm going to get some olive oil because I want that puree to be velvety. Pour that in there. Now, you may need to add a little water. If you do, go ahead. Then we got those diced tomatoes and green chilies. The rest of those in the blender. Then go ahead. You're going to throw the top on there, hit the puree button, and voila! Roasted butternut squash puree. Building time. You're going to start with a layer of that enchilada sauce. Don't know what happened to the picture I took. Then those tortillas. Remember, two different shapes? This is why. You want to fill the corners of that dish. Those irregular pieces you have left over, go ahead and fry them up and make some irregular tortilla chips. Just tell your friends you got them from Ross. Now take that beautiful puree, get that layered in there. Then after that, you're going to get some beans and make it rain. That's not as sexy as I thought it was going to look. Scratch that. All right, next, you're going to get some enchilada sauce on there. And then, there it is. Now that's sexy. Yeah, I like that. Got him. That was beautiful. All right, at this point, guys, all you got to do is just repeat. I'm doing four layers. You can do three or two. It depends on the size of your dish. I'm doing a 9x7, so you should be able to get four layers in there. Once you're done, pop them in the oven, let them go for 30 minutes so those shells can soak up all those layers of goodness. And then all you got to do at this point is wait. I'm going to make me a little side salad. And then once it's done, it's going to be tasting time, y'all. Whew, I can't wait. And there you have it. Only thing left to do now is plate it up. Feeding time. Gotta look at it. Gotta look at it. Yeah. Look at that cheese.
Yeah.
Oh. I'm greedy as hell, y'all. Am I the only one that dance when you eat something good? I know y'all do too. Stop playing. Yeah.
All right. Y'all gonna have to leave me a little bit of privacy right now.
Don't judge. Big G's roasted butternut squash enchilada casserole, y'all.